Hello, Sam. Tonton.
Yeah, Tonton. Hello, Hannah Gadsby. It is lovely to see you. Congrats on the special. It's a very feel-good show, and you kind of mentioned that at the start of the show. Was it important with you, due to your previous work, to set expectations so everyone knew what they were in for?
Yeah, but I don't think people necessarily believe me. A lot of people have said to me, wait for it, just waiting for it. And so I tried to put people at ease, and it turns out I've just made them more nervous about when the twist is going to happen.
Well, it must be hard because obviously you did Nanette, and I feel like Nanette's kind of a point in time. There was before Nanette, after Nanette. And are you aware of the kind of legacy you've had with one of the most important kind of cultural performances of all time? Are you aware of your legacy?
That's a big call right there, Sam Tonton.
Well, I'm happy to make
okay.
it.
Fair enough. But yeah, if I'm going to, you know, enjoy the success, I have to live with the success. Both Douglas and this show are very different from the net, so I feel like I'm setting a precedent pretty quickly that I'm not just a trauma queen.
I am genuinely excited to be here, but it is also very confusing. Like, I'm not a natural host. Like, I've killed the vibe already.
Now, you hosted the Comedy Festival Gala this year, and it's been so exciting to watch your ascent. I know everyone in the comedy community has loved watching it. Is it important to you to come back to Australia and do all the festivals?
You know, you got to prepare for the slide back down, Sam. But also, you know, it is. You know, I feel like this, you know, Nanette sort of cleaved me out of this, you know, the scene in Australia just for what it was. So it was really great to come back. Things have changed in the post-COVID world, and there's some really exciting young voices coming through, so it's great to be back.
Do you find it different working in America to Australia? Audiences are different, what people think about comedy are different. Do you notice the changes?
Yeah, oh, yeah. I'm getting more and more Dave Hughes every day over here. Look, I guess I'm a little spoiled because I toured in America only after Nanette, so it's sort of my audience is my audience. I think if I'd have come over to try and work for clubs, it would have been a much different experience because you can't make a country practice references, I mean.
Yeah, the Home and Away references just don't land the same, do they?
It's only Neighbours and Margot Robbie, that's it.
That's all they care about.
Just for the next hour, we're going to feel good together and then we can head back out there and be the mass extinction event that we are. Are you ready for that?
Now, you filmed something special at the Sydney Opera House. You also filmed Nanette there. It's one of the most famous and recognisable places in the world. How important is the venue to you when you decide you're going to put something out there?
You know, availability is a very important thing. But a nice thing to do is to do a show like something special in the same place and space as Nanette. You know, they're two parts of a human at different times in my life, and that feels special.
I know. I got a birthday present from Jodie Foster. I know.
Now, you name drop Jodie Foster in this special. She gets a huge mention. What is it like having these super famous Hollywood friends? Do you feel the pressure to entertain them?
Look, I'm still enough of a curiosity that people laugh at me anyway. Yeah. The secret is not to hang out with them very much at all.
Yeah, I like that. Just really filter what they experience and control their expectations. That's the perfect way to do it.
Yeah, keep the mystery alive.
Totally. Well, Hannah Gadsby, thank you so much for chatting to us. I love this special. Congratulations on it. And hope to see you back in Australia soon.
Thanks, Sam.
She calls me Tom. That's what friends do.
Oh, my gosh.
Hannah Gadsby, Something Special is on Netflix now.